In-house inquiry committee of the Supreme Court, headed by Justice S.A. Bobde, dismissed the sexual harassment charges in the complaint against Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi. The three-judge panel also gave CJI clean chit and said there was no substance. The panel found no substance in the allegations of sexual harassment leveled against the CJI by a former employee of the Supreme Court. Now we are being joined right now by Managing Editor Times Now, Navika Kumar. Navika, I believe you have a guest currently.
Thanks, Athar. And with the Supreme Court presenting a report which has just been uploaded, the fact is that they've stated that this is a part of the in-house procedure and the report is not liable to be made public. That's what has been stated by the Supreme Court. I'm joined by former Attorney General, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, who's joining me live on this broadcast. Good evening, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, and thank you very much for joining me here on Times Now. Mr. Rohatgi, the Supreme Court three-judge panel report is out. It has just been uploaded on the Supreme Court website. Mr. Rohatgi, many will first of all question on why details of this report are not being made public support of the transparency norms that must be maintained, especially when a female employee had made allegations against a judge of the Supreme Court.
Look, Navika, one has to understand the background of these cases. Now, the judiciary is subject to a large number of vilification complaints because they decide all kinds of cases. So, all kinds of parties are upset with judges in deciding it one way or the other. Therefore, it cannot be equated with any other situation. Now, at the same time, independence of judiciary has to be maintained, otherwise a judge will be unable to function if every day there are allegations against him in normal cases because one party or the other in a case is unhappy with the decision. So now there is an in-house procedure which is prescribed by the Supreme Court. That procedure prescribes that there will be three judges who will head an inquiry. The procedure is that first the Chief Justice will look into it, but here it is the Chief Justice himself. If it is found to be frivolous, then no action is taken. But if some material is found or some allegation looks at least worth looking at, then there is an in-house procedure where the complainant is examined. There is no question of any representation or a lawyer who will cross-examine people. It is an informal procedure to find out whether there is any material or not. Because if it is found that there is material, then some other action can be taken, which can be impeachment, can be removal, can be a criminal case, etc. So this is an informal committee by the peers of the judge concerned. There is a set procedure. That procedure has been followed. And as you know, this lady had walked out of this committee after appearing for one day or 2 days. I don't know why she walked out. She was entitled to give whatever material she had. Now that the report is out, because of the sensitive nature of a duty of a judge consistent with independence of judiciary, these reports cannot be made public.
But Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, many will question two facts in the procedure that has been followed. Fact number one, if this concerned lady has walked out of deposition before the said committee of the Supreme Court judges panel, number one, what is the sanctity of such an investigation, such a report, such an examination of the entire situation? And number two, the Vishakha guidelines have been formed by the Supreme Court itself, in which an outside member should have been on the panel. Why should the Supreme Court not follow the guidelines that it has prescribed itself for the rest of the country in cases such as these?
No, Navika, firstly, when the complainant walks out, that doesn't mean that the inquiry comes to an end. I mean, if you are dissatisfied with the merits of a decision, you can't walk out. I mean, When we appear in cases, if the court is deciding against us, we don't walk out of the inquiry. The inquiry is by three judges, which was, you know, which had two lady members in it. Then the complainant should have gone ahead, and walking out doesn't mean that the inquiry comes to an end. And secondly, in the in-house procedure established by the Supreme Court, there is no case or occasion for an outside member at all. The word in-house itself means judgment or judging or a look by the peers of the judge. The peers of the judge are sitting judges. Now, we can't have a politician or a businessman or somebody else, you know, as a part of this committee. It's a very, very sensitive and a very, very delicate issue. Please understand, a judge decides all kinds of cases all the time. There are a large number of forces which may be out to damn the reputation of a judge who may have decided a particular case one way or a particular case another way. That is why this procedure has been adopted. And this procedure, mind you, is not to find ultimate guilt or ultimate, the end of these things. It is really to find that is there any credible material in the complaint. If there is credible material, then there are further steps. What has been found in this case, that there is no credible material even at a preliminary stage. If there is no credible material, then it must end now, and the judge concerned or the Chief Justice in a given case cannot be subject to further glare of the media or other people, but Mr. Rohatgi,
there is an argument that the three judges panel that was set up, Justice Bobde, Justice Indira Banerjee and Justice Indu Malhotra, now all of these, in a manner of speaking, are reporting to the Chief Justice of India, or rather the Chief Justice of India is the chief of all of these judges. In such a situation, you know, does this panel itself have any credibility? And shouldn't the Chief Justice not have stepped aside from his position if the credibility to this in-house committee had to be given?
No, Navika, let us understand the basics. There is a basic fallacy in what you are saying. A Chief Justice is not superior to any other judge of the Supreme Court. Even if a judge is appointed today and is a one-day-old judge in the Supreme Court, he is not junior or inferior to the Chief Justice who may have been in the Supreme Court for the last 5 to 7 years. A Chief Justice is only one amongst the equals. His only power is to create benches and look at how there will be administration of justice. His judicial power is not even 1% more than any other judge. Please understand, there are no senior judges or junior judges in terms of merit. All judges of the court are identical. Their judicial power is the same. No judge reports to any other judge, much less the Chief Justice. The Chief Justice, as I told you, is only entitled to create benches as to which judge will sit where and will decide what kind of cases. That is about all. He has no additional power. So there is no reporting of any judge, much less these three judges, to report to anybody else. That's how Mr. Rohatgi,
the question now becomes that in the first instance, when this case was taken up on a Saturday by the Supreme Court with the Chief Justice himself sitting on that panel to hear the arguments, do you think that itself was not correct procedure? How can anybody be a judge in their own case?
Let me put it this way. Yeah, you are right. The judge cannot be a judge in his own case. But according to me, from what I see and how it happened, this came as a bolt from the blue, and at 8 o'clock in the morning, it was on all websites like Wire and others. According to me, the Chief Justice sitting on the bench may be inappropriate, but it was an anguish of a person with 40 or 50 years, 40 years of being in the profession as a lawyer and a judge, who's been an upright judge, never had any other complaint of any kind, and that was his anguish speaking in the court. And that is why he used phrases like, what is his wealth and what is the amount in his bank account. It was only anguish, and maybe he realized that he shouldn't have sat on the bench, and that is why neither did he sign the order, and even the two other judges who passed a four-line order themselves declared that it was hardly a judicial order. It was only a request to the media not to play it up, because apart from an individual, it was the dignity of the institution and how people look at that institution which was involved. But yes, if you want it in one line, the Chief Justice should not have sat on the bench. But I am giving you what I feel is what must have happened in the mind of a particular individual.
But Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, you said that the Chief Justice himself has taken decisions on many cases, which is why there may be people who may be opposed to him. Could you elaborate on that, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi? Are there people, are there procedures in the court brought to the notice of the Chief Justice, and has he taken any action on some of these incidents within the court which has created a situation where people are gunning for the Chief Justice?
Look, Navika, every judge of the Supreme Court decides very, very important cases, whether it be of environment, whether they be political, whether they be commercial fights. Those judges decide very, very important and far-reaching cases. You know, cases involving 5,000 crores, 10,000 crores, 50,000 crores. I mean, these are the level of cases which are decided apart from political cases or environmental cases. Now, God knows who wants to, you know, have a swipe at a particular judge, whether Chief Justice or any other judge. I have not, in this case, found any, there is no real credible evidence available today as to whether some lobby was working or not working. Every Chief Justice tries to streamline the working of the judiciary. In fact, 2 months ago, one particular bench of the court found that one staff of the court was probably writing a wrong order as compared to what was dictated. Some action was taken, the chaps were arrested, and all those things are going on. So there is no clear position as to whether somebody has ruffled some feathers, etc. And let me tell you, from my experience, the Chief Justice is an honest and an upright man. He may be a little abrasive and short-tempered in court because he finishes his cases very fast. But I have never come across any other allegation. And let me tell you, the barometer of a judge is always the bar. The bar knows everything about the judge, how he has worked as a lawyer, how he has behaved as a judge. And I have no manner of doubt, and I said a couple of days ago that I don't find that there is any credible complaint in this regard. Maybe the complainant had some axe to grind. I don't know what was the axe. Maybe the axe was that the complainant was facing and her husband was facing criminal cases, and maybe with this kind of thing, he may have tried to see that those cases come to an end, and that led to some kind of a spat, and that led to this. That's how I.
Mr. Rohatgi, before I let you go, I just want to ask you one question.
Is now to stop all this and finish it.
Mr. Rohatgi, before I let you go, I want to ask you just one question. Has this entire episode really hit at the credibility of the one remaining institution which people of this country had looked up to for justice? The Supreme Court of India.
Well, I think it has affected the credibility and dignity of the court. But let me tell you, the court is very resilient. It always bounces back, because that's the last forum for the entire public to look at. The court bounced back after the emergency. According to me, the darkest period of the Supreme Court was the emergency. These things have come and gone, but they cannot rock or crack the roots of the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court will bounce back. The inquiry is now out. It shows that there was no material. and you cannot accuse all the three judges by saying that they are kowtowing with the Chief Justice. They are all judges, including the senior most judge after the CJ, who will become CJ in November. So we should accept what the three judges have said. We should put a lid over it. We should look forward. Supreme Court's image has rocked, but it will remain steady after a couple of days, and I think we will be on the right path. Please understand, it was rocked a couple of months last year also, but the court bounced back. It will always bounce back, and these irritants will not come in the way of the Supreme Court marching ahead.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi. We do hope for the sake of this country, for the sake of the citizens of this country, that this institution weathers all storms, because it is important for the people of this country to continue to have their faith in this great institution that provides justice to the poorest of poor, to every single citizen of India. Thank you, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, for joining me on Times Now.